I've got three poems for you all tonight. Huge crowd here this evening. Very first of all, this is about a labyrinth that's at my work, and it was made just a couple years ago, and it's already being reclaimed by nature. So here it is, Labyrinth. The poison oak sprig stands alert with its thin sheen of oil, its few leaves so bright with the red and gold of autumn hills of the east. And the ivy has grown its inevitable way past the bricks of the border, whose line has been shifted by roots twisting under the ground, and the bricks, which were formed of red clay, torn out cold out of some mountainside, and were baked in a kiln to be very even, if rough, have moss growing on them and through them, and sink in the duff and topsoil that threatens to claim who is carefully placed to outline a maze between ivy and trees, paths wide enough for one human to walk through, walls one brick high, spiraling into the center and out the same way, placed a few years ago and already reclaimed of earth and the plants of the earth, and the rain floating rivers of duff through the paths of the maze, and the wind all unheeding of human cleared spaces that brings what it will, and the moles and the worms and the other small creatures that burrow beneath, and the mushrooms all secret that grow with the trees underground, spreading thin unseen tendrils in circular form until rain sprouts their fruits, which will grow in a ring round the brickwork, enclosing the ring of the labyrinth so carefully laid out, not yet 5 years past.
Wow. Yeah.
Thank you. And now I've got two different ones of more personal meaning, personal experience. The first is Rainy Day Love Song. I am unprotected, a buffoon and clumsy, with my collar flapping in the wind. One-celled animals are hatching in my flesh. Approach me softly, come with grace and sympathy, or do not come at all. My nerves are worn, as are the knees and all my trousers, so worn they feel like soft, smooth linen. I see you grayly behind mist, cannot tell if you are moving forward. Approach me like you would some skittish autumn animal trapped out collecting berries for the coming brutal season. I will not stoop to eat the corn you throw to me. Come with your hands outstretched, or stay there misty, indistinct, a shade by all these other shades that come between us, shoulders down and hands in pockets. So many people have so many dreams, and just to have them dream them, tear their faces with their ragged nails. Come to me formed and polished as you please, and stand erect. All infants are four-legged. Approach me now the way a cat approaches, or you can leave me in this mindless hour. And this third poem has three distinct voices running through it. There's a third person, second person, and first person. Third person is what I'm projecting people say about me. Second person is things people were saying to me. And the first person is me speaking as myself. This is called Grazing Dinosaurs for Shame. See here, she moves like something is missing, like in a dream of things primordial, long-tailed, scooted dinosaurs that skulk around the bushes. Shame. To wonder why the next who speaks repeats the thing you said, receives the gentle laugh. To think, to chit-chat. Just be content that no one speaks and swing tails of horseshoe crabs avoid your legs. Out there, the whales collide with ships, the kraken dance. My love, whose ears are just like shells, I hear the ocean pressed against them, knows. The fairies hate a liar and a thief. My love, whose eyes are alabaster, knows. You plumped up like a dumpling, firm and ragged. Look at me when you speak. You asked if there were rules to being real. She moves like in a nightmare of the England overrun by wolves. So let the forest have her if it comes to that. For shame. The 8-foot terror cranes would once strode tall the savannah, snatching horses. The name that many races call themselves is only people. My love is this, someone who lies about all day in peace on cushions, whose eyes are alabaster, whose ears you only see. My love holds water,
My love can stare and stare as something makes the noise of 10 outsided crowds outside our door. You are a walker, ragged shoes and hobnailed feet and toes clawed like a raptor, but arms as far from graceful noble wings as steel is far from cardboard in the road, all tracked with mud-soaked treads. Tired and with pupils spread like dull and rusty pans, she stays awake that time that could be any day. Why can you not be like the rest who chit-chat? It's just like talking to a syphilitic. No taste in clothes, no sense of urgency. God give that to a flea. Fairies in the corners glare with all the hate they have for mortal folk. Milk curdles in your place. Things move and letters from your words go missing. Be real and true or things go badly. Shame.